Yes, from here to the Blue Mountains, rabid and ravenous, he bites and bites away. Men of the North, you stand at the precipice. Your king.
All right, welcome back to another episode of Septimore Plays The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. Started the questline with the Bloody Baron last night, so gonna continue with that now, trying to find his family before he'll give us information on the girl that we're looking for, Ciri, I believe her name is. Messing that up. Yeah. So, let's begin.
The Witcher's contact in Velen was to be Hendrik, the Emperor's spy. Hendrik was operating incognito in that war-ravaged land. His mission, to gather intelligence about Ciri. Yet Geralt arrived too late. The Wild Hunt had reached Hendrik first. The Witcher learned nothing from the spy's corpse, but the wraiths had failed to find his notes. Geralt read them and knew that Ciri had been a guest of the Bloody Baron, a local warlord, and that she'd quarreled with a witch.
Alright, so we're on a Princess in Distress quest. Find the Pillar's Goat using the bell and your Witcher senses. Oh, that's probably where I gotta go.
This way, I think.
Where'd that goat go? Not backwards. What's that? Oh, wolves. What are you doing on the ground? See something red in the distance. Oh. These are just more footprints. Another wolf. I hear a goat. I hear it. Coming.
There you are.
Here's Princess.
Goat. Here, Princess. Hoofed and horned. Should have known it would be stubborn.
All right. Pallor's Bell, which is what? R-F-T-Y. Bring the goat to Pell. How do I use that bell?
Come on,
there it
let's
is.
Go see the Peller.
Let's go!
Come on, take you back to the Peller. Misses you something awful. Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow? Come on, damn it.
Come on, Princess.
Where the hell do you go?
I really gotta stay by him. Go. Uh-oh.
Bear.
Whoa!
Bear. Run.
Yep, should have dodged that one. Good night. That was a big bear. Holy shit. Where'd he go?
Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow? You're no roach, but I bet we could be friends in time. You've got that all-important quality every roach has to have. You don't talk much.
Nowhere in sight. Nowhere to be found.
Right here, man!
Flee not from the pillar, for there are wolves about. Goat of mine! Dearest, sweetest goat.
Oh boy.
Happy for you, but I'm kinda in a hurry. Anna and Tamara, they might be in danger.
The white wolf helped the Pella, and so the Pella shall help him. Blood. We need blood. A living being.
Fine. Be right back. Do.
What the fuck are we doing with this rat? Oh boy. He's already dead, so. Nothing we can do there.
There is God. Blood. I see blood.
Whose?
No one. No Tamara. Just the child. A child that lives not, yet did not die.
It's over. Is that it?
That is it.
Spirits had nothing more to say? Like where they went or where they are now?
You came for an augury, and augur I did. They're gone, the child remains.
Mentioned a child.
Whose? Why, Anna's.
Anna was pregnant?
She was. And she miscarried.
Baron didn't mention it.
Afraid, perhaps. Or ashamed, or forgetful. Or perhaps he had no wish to remember.
Anna tell you all this? Did she come here after it happened?
Nay, not Anna. 'Twas the omens told me.
Great, so I can be sure it's true.
The omens need not your faith to be true. It is you who needs the omens to lead you to truth.
The Baron have anything to do with his wife's miscarriage?
Foul-tempered he is, and he's a fondness for hooch.
No doubt makes his temper even fouler. Did he abuse his family? Anna came to you, you must have noticed something.
The Pella's old, near blind. But Princess came and licked her hand.
So what?
She's a wise beast. Only comes to those who suffer.
Child.
in a grave thrown, without rite or ceremony, it awoke. Now it wanders, it seeks vengeance.
A botchling.
White wolf, wise wolf, catch the botchling. The botchling will help. Lead the wolf to the loved ones.
Botchlings suck the blood of pregnant women and eat their fetuses. They don't help.
Tis a being cursed, and witches lift curses. If the white wolf can't lift it, he should bring me its blood. Blood will always find kindred blood.
Why do you need its blood?
Why do you want its blood?
Blood. Blood, blood. It binds men for all ages, the living and the dead.
Sure, but what do you want to do with it?
At times, a century is too short for two brothers to reconcile. One dies before things are set right. The other then brings his blood to the Peller.
Mm-hmm. And what does the Peller do?
He awaits Forefather's Eve. He mixes the blood with milk, herbs, and hen's feet. He drinks to reconcile the dead with the living. There shall be no Forefather's Eve this year. But we'll find a way, all the same.
Heard of one witcher who lifted a botchling's curse. Never tried it myself, though. I know you need to bury it under the threshold.
And give it a name. Perform the I'm Roin.
The ritual of naming. That's an elven custom.
Human, elven, dwarven, ancient. Spirits have no race. They honor not its meaning. Win a spirit's favor, and the spirit shall aid you. Ask, and it will answer. Seek, and it will show you the way.
I hear you right. You mentioned Forefather's Eve. Pretty old custom. Thought it had died out.
Death lurks in every bog and puddle round here. Folk know they could die, their earthly matters unresolved. Then they require help, or they'll not know peace. Forefather's Eve must be performed. Light the tallow candles to lead them through the dark. Call them by name, appease their regrets. Only then may they depart in peace.
Alright, need to know where the botchling is.
Whatever I do, I gotta find the botchling first.
Seek it at midnight, near the grave that lies empty.
If what you say is true, the Baron ought to know where that grave is.
Alright, back to the Baron. Roach, where you at? There he is. Trusty steed.
That's it, Roach.
Why that auto run? I don't know how to do it right. It like goes on the path, but it doesn't follow the dots, which you would think it would.
Killers!
Oh no! The castle? Go that way or this way? Fuck you, Roach. Just run myself. Jesus.
Oswin? Where's Oswin? Anyone seen him?
Believe I saw him heading to the stable.
What?
Fire. You blind? Nobody willing to put it out?
Ain't that simple. Most are afraid.
Baron flies into a rage. He takes no prisoners.
My brother's in the stable. We've got to save him. He'll burn alive. Him and the horses.
All right. I'll try.
See what I can do.
Hurry now, quick!
Use special grindstones to temporarily enhance your weapon. Doing so grants bonus dealt by your weapons. Okay. Save the stable hand. The horse is trapped in the burning stable. Okay. Change that. There we go. Need hard, right? Is that what I have? Where do I go? Someone's hammered.
Why, I'm prepared to forgive you the drubbing you gave those pricks at the crossroads.
I know your wife miscarried. Was that before or after you beat her to a pulp?
What the fuck are you suggesting?
Don't play me for a fool. You'd been beating them for years. Finally, they'd had enough and fled. Sound about right?
Ah! Oh, shit. They're hammered.
They ran from me, didn't they? We need to talk.
Yep, we definitely do.
Sit down. You beat them.
I never laid a finger on Tamara. Not once.
And on Anna?
That's another story. She always knew how to spark my ire.
Your wife? How'd she make you angry? Too much salt in the soup? Socks never darned?
20 years we've known each other. She's seen me drunk and sober. She was there to greet me when I returned the victor. She was there to patch me up in defeat. Like no other, she knew where to press, where to pinch, so it would hurt.
You beat her? For that? For criticizing you?
Oh, Witcher, you haven't a clue, have you? Well, perhaps I shall tell you about it one day. One day, but not today.
Never hit your daughter?
Expect me to believe you are a loving father to Tamara after that scene in the courtyard?
You're free to believe whatever you wish, but she was always the apple of my eye. She had the run of the place, ask anyone. She'd ride the horses, hunt with the men, at times join them on their rounds. And they'd send for her when I flew into a rage, for only she could calm me.
Make it sound like she led a charmed life. If that's the case, why'd she run?
I'd hardly need you if I knew.
You knew they ran away.
You knew they had run away from the start.
Yes, I knew.
Why didn't you tell me? Wasted my time.
Say I had. Say I'd said I had troubles. Couldn't control my wife, my daughter. What kind of flaccid prick would you take me for?
Gotta admit, I do think you're a prick. Not because you couldn't control them, but because you drove them away.
What?
Don't play the idiot. You gave them no choice.
Anna and I. It wasn't as it seemed. Seems.
All right, I'm all ears. Tell me what happened. The truth this time.
I'd been soaking myself 3 days straight. Anna came to me, said they were leaving. I begged them to stay. She refused to hear it. I tried to stop her. She wriggled like an eel. We struggled. She fell. Last blasted thing I remember. Woke up in the morn, breeches heavy with my own piss. A large bump on my head. Sadly, they were gone. Know what that's like, Witcher? No. How the fuck could you? I was left with nothing. Nothing! Only the bottle.
What about the signs of fighting in the room?
Signs of a fight in the room. Hole in the wall, wine all over the landing. Was that you?
Oi. We tussled. She tried to whack me on the noggin with a candlestick, but kept missing. Hit the wall and a pillar instead. I staggered backwards onto the table, spilled the wine, slipped and tumbled. Anna used that moment to flee. She rushed down the stairs, still clutching that damn candlestick. I caught her on the landing. We fell. I thought I had her. Then she turned and smacked me in the head. I blacked out. Don't know what happened next. When I came to, I was alone.
Tamara witnessed this?
Tamara present for all
Tamara.
This.
Tamara.
She see you quarrel.
Through the doorway, perhaps. She didn't enter the room. Shame, too. Things might have turned out differently. The sight of her always calmed me.
What happened next?
Next? It only got worse. I awoke at sunset, not knowing how many days had passed. Thought it was all a ploughing, drunken nightmare. And then I went to the bedchamber, and Anna was not there. Instead, there was blood everywhere. I knew she'd miscarried. My breath short, my throat locked. I neared the bed and saw it. It lay there, tiny thing, defenseless, on bloodied sheets, dead. And it was my doing.
What'd you do with the child?
Maybe you're doing, maybe not. But that amulet she wore could be important, or maybe the fact that she lost it. What did you do with the child?
What was I to do? Took it out and buried it.
Just like that?
Damn you! I gave no thought to a funeral. It was a horror. I wanted it to end. That child had been my dream. I told Anna, the little one, our little one, to make things right. Yet she died before she could be born.
This is heavy.
Understand, Witcher. My child was dead.